Hey everybody, this is Brijesh here, और आप देख रहे हैं CABA Infoventry। दोस्तों, इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट आप पर यानी के अपने SSCs पर बहुत ज्यादा विश्वास करता है। आप भी कहेंगे सर आप मजाक कर रहे हैं। नहीं नहीं दोस्तों, मैं मजाक नहीं कर रहा हूं, बल्कि आपसे रियलिटी शेयर कर रहा हूं। जब बात टैक्स कलेक्शन की आती है तो इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट आप पर यानी कि अपने SSCs पर ही भरोसा करता है, चाहे वो TDS हो या TCS, यानी कि टैक्स डिडक्शन एट सोर्स और टैक्स कलेक्शन एट सोर्स। आप कहेंगे सर हमने तो सुना है इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट खूब रेट्स डालता है अपने SSCs पर, तो ये क्या उसके विश्वास का साइन है अपने SSCs पर? दोस्तों, इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट किसी पर्सन पर रेट तब डालता है जब उसके पास पक्की एविडेंस होती है या इंफॉर्मेशन होती है कि कोई व्यक्ति अपनी जितनी इनकम है उसको वो डिक्लेयर नहीं कर रहा है और उस पर ड्यू टैक्स पे नहीं कर रहा है। जहां तक आप पर यानी SSCs पर विश्वास की बात है भाई इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट, तो ये भरोसा आपको दिखता है वेरियस TDS और TCS प्रोविजंस में, जिसमें उनको कलेक्शन करने की जिम्मेवारी आप पर यानी SSCs पर डाली है इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट ने। तो क्या ये इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट का आप पर भरोसा नहीं जताता है? Enough is enough. Now we should talk serious business. Finance Act 2021 introduced Section 194Q, which is applicable with effect from 1st July 2021. Section 194Q is similar to Section 206C1H, which was introduced by Finance Act 2020 to collect tax at source on transactions between a buyer and seller. While Section 206C1H imposes a liability on the seller to collect tax, that is TCS, from buyer, that is the tax incidence falls on buyer. Section 194Q, on the other hand, imposes a liability on the buyer to deduct tax, that is TDS, while paying to the seller, that is the tax incidence falls on the seller. Now I will discuss with you the key elements of the Section 194Q. Provisions of Section 194Q would apply to a buyer whose total sales, gross receipts or turnover from business carried on by him exceeds rupees 10 crore during the financial year immediately preceding the financial year in which the goods are purchased. Means, if total sales, gross receipts or turnover from the business carried on by him during the financial year 2020-21 exceeds rupees 10 crore, it further provides that such tax is to be deducted on purchase of goods only from a seller who is resident of India under the provisions of the Income Tax Act. The rate prescribed for deduction of tax is 0.1% of the value or aggregate value of the goods that exceeds rupees 50 lakh in the financial year. Tax would be required to be deducted at higher rate of 5% if the seller does not hold a PAN in India. As per Section 206AA of the Act, as applicable in case of other TDS provisions, liability to deduct TDS would arise at the time of credit or payment, whichever is earlier, and would include any sum credited to any account, whether called by name, suspense account, or by any other name. The above provision of deduction of tax at source on purchase of goods is not applicable in the cases like where tax is deductible under any other provisions of the Act and where tax is collected under Section 206C of the Act, except two transactions covered under Section 206C(1)(h). It is also to be noted that this section is applicable on sale of goods only, and services have presently been kept out of the ambit of this section. Therefore, the limit of Rs. 50 lakh for each financial year have to be taken for the purchase of goods alone. Ab aapke man mein tarah tarah ke questions aa rahe honge is provision ke bare mein, like kis kis ko ye tax deduct karna padega, kaun kaun si types ke SSEs like individual aur firms par ye applicable hoga, ye keval goods ke upar applicable hoga ya ye services ke upar bhi applicable hoga, इस टैक्स को कब डिडक्ट करना पड़ेगा? अगर बायर गुड्स को आउटसाइड इंडिया से इंपोर्ट करता है तो क्या उस पर भी ये सेक्शन एप्लीकेबल होगा? जब गुड्स को आउटसाइड इंडिया एक्सपोर्ट किया जाता है तो क्या उस पर भी ये प्रोविजन लागू होगा? किस किस चीज को गुड्स माना जाएगा? क्या सिक्योरिटीज का ट्रांजेक्शन जो कि स्टॉक एक्सचेंज के थ्रू किया जाता है उस पर भी ये प्रोविजन लागू होगा? अगर मैं कैपिटल गुड्स परचेज करता हूं तो क्या उस पर भी ये लागू होगा? क्या इलेक्ट्रिसिटी के ट्रांजैक्शन पर भी ये लागू होगा? क्या परचेज ऑफ सॉफ्टवेयर के केस में भी ये प्रोविजन लागू होगा? क्या टीडीएस उस केस में भी डिडक्ट करना पड़ेगा जहां पर ज्वेलरी परचेज की गई है लेकिन वो बिजनेस पर्पस के लिए नहीं परचेज की गई है? किस डेट से ये 50 लाख की थ्रेशोल्ड कंप्यूट की जाएगी? टीडीएस किस वैल्यू पर काटना होगा? क्या ये टोटल इनवॉइस वैल्यू पर काटना होगा इंक्लूडिंग जीएसटी या विदाउट जीएसटी? अगर हमने सेलर को एडवांस पेमेंट किया है तो क्या उस पर भी टीडीएस काटना होगा? ऐसे और बहुत सारे सवाल आपके मन में आ रहे होंगे इस प्रोविजन के बारे में। दोस्तों, घबराइए नहीं, मैं आपको इन सवालों का जवाब दूंगा, और इसलिए आप इस वीडियो के अंत तक बने रहिए जिससे कि आपके सारे डाउट क्लियर हो जाएं। अगर उसके बाद भी आपके कुछ डाउट्स क्लियर नहीं होते हैं तो आप कमेंट बॉक्स में पोस्ट कर दीजिए, मैं उनको क्लियर करने की पूरी कोशिश करूंगा। तो आइए अब मैं शुरू करता हूं आपके इन क्वेश्चंस को क्लियर करना, उनका आंसर देकर, जिससे कि जो भी डाउट आपके मन में है वो पूरी तरह से क्लियर हो जाएं। तो दोस्तों, आपका सबसे पहला क्वेश्चन होगा कि कौन कौन लोग सेक्शन 194Q के अंदर टैक्स डिडक्ट करने के लिए लायबल है। दोस्तों, टैक्स शैल बी डिडक्टेड अंडर सेक्शन 194Q बाय ए बायर कैरिंग ऑन ए बिजनेस हुज टोटल सेल्स, ग्रॉस रिसीट्स और टर्नओवर फ्रॉम द बिजनेस एक्सीड्स ₹10 crore ड्यूरिंग द फाइनेंशियल ईयर इमीडिएटली प्रीसीडिंग द फाइनेंशियल ईयर इन विच सच गुड्स आर परचेस्ड। दिस प्रोविजन शैल बी एप्लीकेबल from 1st of July 2021. Therefore, the liability to deduct tax in financial year 2021-22 shall arise if the turnover of the purchaser was more than rupees 10 crore in financial year 2020-21.
अब आप पूछेंगे कि क्या टैक्स डिडक्ट करने की लाइबिलिटी सभी तरह के एसएससीज के ऊपर एप्लीकेबल होगी, लाइक इंडिविजुअल्स, फर्म्स और कंपनीज? जी हां दोस्तों, टैक्स डिडक्ट करने की लाइबिलिटी सभी तरह के एसएससीज के ऊपर लागू होगी, चाहे वो इंडिविजुअल हो या फर्म हो या कंपनी। अब आप पूछेंगे कि कब ये टैक्स डिडक्ट करना पड़ेगा? तो दोस्तों, टैक्स शैल बी डिडक्टेड फ्रॉम परचेजेस मेड बाय ए बायर इफ दीज कंडीशंस आर सेटिस्फाइड, दैट इज देयर इज ए परचेज ऑफ गुड्स फ्रॉम ए रेजिडेंट पर्सन। नंबर टू, गुड्स आर परचेज्ड फॉर एग्रीगेट ऑफ वैल्यू एक्सीडिंग रुपीज 50 लाख इन एनी प्रीवियस ईयर। एंड नंबर थ्री, द बायर शुड नॉट बी इन द लिस्ट ऑफ पर्संस एक्सक्लूडेड फ्रॉम द प्रोविजंस फॉर डिडक्शन ऑफ टैक्स। सो फ्रेंड्स, टैक्स शैल नॉट बी डिडक्टेड अंडर दिस प्रोविजन इफ द टैक्स इज डिडक्टेबल और कलेक्टेबल अंडर एनी अदर प्रोविजंस एक्सेप्ट सेक्शन 206(c)(1)(h). दस, इफ यू ट्रांजेक्शन इज सब्जेक्ट टू TCS अंडर सेक्शन 206(c)(1)(h), द बायर शैल हैव द फर्स्ट ऑब्लिगेशन टू डिडक्ट द टैक्स। इफ ही डज सो, द सेलर विल नॉट हैव एनी ऑब्लिगेशन टू कलेक्ट द टैक्स अंडर सेक्शन 206(c)(1)(h). अब आप पूछेंगे कि टैक्स डिडक्शन की टाइमिंग क्या होगी? तो दोस्तों, टैक्स इज रिक्वायर्ड टू बी डिडक्टेड एट द टाइम ऑफ क्रेडिट ऑफ सच अमाउंट टू द अकाउंट ऑफ सेलर और एट द टाइम ऑफ पेमेंट देयर ऑफ बाय एनी मोड विच एवर इज अर्लियर। टैक्स शैल बी डिडक्टेड इवन इफ द अमाउंट इज क्रेडिटेड टू सस्पेंस अकाउंट। अब आपके दिमाग में ये क्वेश्चन आ रहा होगा कि एक बार जो कंसिडरेशन है, अमाउंट है फॉर परचेज ऑफ गुड्स, तो अगर वो 50 लाख रुपए से ज्यादा हो जाता है तो उस कंडीशन में क्या एंटायर कंसिडरेशन या अमाउंट यानी के 50 लाख रुपए के ऊपर TDS काटना होगा या केवल 50 लाख रुपए के ऊपर का जो अमाउंट होता है उस पर TDS काटना होगा? तो दोस्तों, सेक्शन 194(q) रिक्वायर्स फॉर डिडक्शन ऑफ टैक्स एट द रेट ऑफ 0.1% ऑफ द अमाउंट एक्सीडिंग रुपीज 50 लाख इन ए फाइनेंशियल ईयर। हेंस, टैक्स शैल बी डिडक्टेड एट सोर्स on the consideration or amount that exceeds rupees 50 lakh. For example, in a case where the first purchase was made for rupees 35 lakh and the second purchase was made for rupees 40 lakh, the TDS should be deducted only on the second purchase and only on the amount of rupees 25 lakh, that is rupees 35 lakh plus 40 lakh minus 50 lakh. This threshold of rupees 50 lakh shall apply year wise. अब आप पूछेंगे कि मैं किस रेट से उस पर टैक्स डिडक्ट करूंगा? तो दोस्तों, टैक्स शैल बी डिडक्टेड बाय द बायर ऑफ द गुड्स एट द रेट ऑफ 0.1% of the purchase value exceeding rupees 50 lakh if the seller has furnished his PAN. Otherwise, the tax shall be deducted at the rate of 5%. The applicable rate of 5% is subject to fulfillment of conditions, namely non-filing of return of income for last 2 years एंड एग्रीगेट ऑफ टैक्स डिडक्टेड एट सॉर्ट्स एंड TCS इज ₹50,000 और मोर इन ईच ऑफ दीज टू ईयर्स एज पर द न्यूली इंसर्टेड सेक्शन 206AB बाय फाइनेंस एक्ट 2021। अब आप पूछेंगे कि अगर एक ट्रांजेक्शन दोनों प्रोविजंस यानी के TDS अंडर सेक्शन 194Q एंड TCS अंडर सेक्शन 206C1H दोनों में कवर्ड है तो कौन से सेक्शन में लायबल होगा फॉर डिडक्शन ऑफ टैक्स और कलेक्शन ऑफ टैक्स। If buyer is liable to deduct tax under any other provision on the good purchased by him from the seller and has deducted such amount, no tax shall be collected on the same transaction. Though section 206C1H excludes a transaction on which tax is actually deducted under any other provisions which will cover section 194Q as well, but section 194Q5 does not create a similar exception for a transaction on which tax is collectible under section 206C1H. Thus, the buyer shall have the primary and foremost obligation to deduct tax and no tax shall be collected on such transaction under section 206C1H. However, if the buyer makes a default, the liability to collect the tax gets shifted to the seller. Both these provisions are shown to you with the help of example on the screen, where buyer and seller might be in an uncertain condition as to who should deduct the tax. The primary responsibility lies on purchaser to deduct the tax. To avoid the ambiguous situation, buyer may provide the declaration to seller stating that he would be deducting taxes at the time of booking invoice or at the time of making advance payment, wherever applicable. Seller should also provide a declaration stating that he has filed the IDR for last two relevant previous years as mentioned in section 206AB. Ab aap puchenge ki agar buyer goods import kar raha hai from outside India, क्या तब भी उसको टैक्स डिडक्ट करना पड़ेगा एट सोर्स अंडर दिस सेक्शन। दोस्तों, ऑब्लिगेशन टू डिडक्ट टैक्स अंडर दिस प्रोविजन अराइजेस ओनली व्हेन द पेमेंट इज मेड टू अ रेजिडेंट सेलर। इन द केस ऑफ इंपोर्ट द सेलर इज अ नॉन रेजिडेंट, देयरफॉर बायर विल नॉट हैव any obligation to deduct tax under this provision. The buyer may take a declaration regarding the residential status of the seller. However, the TDS or payment of equalization levy may be required in respect of such transactions. In case of purchase of goods through high sea sales transaction, this exception may not be applicable as the high sea seller may be a resident. अब आप पूछेंगे कि क्या अगर मैं goods export करता हूँ outside the country, तब भी क्या मुझे tax deduct करना पड़ेगा under section 194Q? दोस्तों, liability to deduct tax under this provision arises only when the payment is made to a resident seller. Residential status of the buyer who is making payment is not relevant under this provision, as in the transaction of export of goods, the seller is a resident, but the buyer is a non-resident. Thus, the liability to deduct tax under this provision may arise on the non-resident buyer. However, it is a cumbersome exercise of determining the satisfaction of all the conditions of Section 194Q and Section 206AB, availability of pen, etc. I hope that CBDT may come out with necessary clarification in this regard shortly. Ab aap puchenge, kis cheez ko as a purchase of goods mana jayega? Kyunki goods ki to koi definition available hai nahi. My dear friends, term goods is not defined under Income Tax Act. Term goods has wide meaning. Anything which comes to the market can be treated as goods. However, term goods has been defined under the Sale of Goods Act and Central Goods and Services Act 2017. Sale of Goods Act defines goods means every kind of movable property other than actionable claims and money, and includes stock and shares, growing crops, grass, and things attached to or forming part of the land which are agreed to be severed before sale or under the contract of sale. You may have a look at the list of goods as defined under various legislations, which is displayed on the screen. अब आप पूछेंगे कि अगर मैं ट्रांजैक्शन करता हूं सिक्योरिटीज में थ्रू ए स्टॉक एक्सचेंज, तो क्या वो भी टीडीएस के दायरे में आएगा? That will come under TDS provisions. Whether TDS will be required in case of investment in units of the mutual fund. Friends, when Finance Act 2020 introduced Section 206C1H to provide for collection of tax on the sale of goods, concerns were raised about the applicability of such provision in respect of transactions through stock exchange or commodity exchange, as there is no one-to-one contact between the buyer and seller. In respect of the above, CBDT White Circular Number 17 of 2020 clarified that provisions of Section 206C1H shall not be applicable in relation to transactions in securities and commodities which are traded through recognized stock exchanges or cleared and settled by the recognized clearing corporations, including recognized stock exchanges or recognized clearing corporations located in International Financial Services Center, that is IFSC. Applying the rationale behind such clarification, it can be inferred that the CBDT may allow a similar exemption from TDS under Section 194Q as well. A suitable clarification from CBDT is the need of R. Dosto, अब आप पूछेंगे कि अगर मैं कैपिटल गुड्स परचेस करता हूं तो क्या उस पर भी मुझे टीडीएस डिडक्ट करना पड़ेगा? As explained just now, that goods means every kind of movable property subject to certain exceptions and inclusions, irrespective of whether it is capital goods or not. Hence, TDS is to be deducted on purchase of capital goods also. 106AB. अब आप पूछेंगे, अगर बायर सर्विस इंडस्ट्री में है और वो गुड्स परचेस करता है किसी सेलर से, तो क्या उसको टीडीएस डिडक्ट करना पड़ेगा? फ्रेंड्स, बायर मींस ए पर्सन हुज टोटल सेल्स, ग्रॉस रिसीट्स और टर्नओवर फ्रॉम द बिजनेस कैरीड ऑन बाय हिम एक्सीड्स 10 crore rupees during the financial year immediately preceding the financial year in which the purchase of goods is made, as explained by me earlier, as per section 213 of the Income Tax Act. Business includes any trade, commerce or manufacture or any adventure or concern in the nature of trade, commerce or manufacture. Therefore, we can infer that business includes services also. And if the buyer is a service provider, he has to deduct TDS on purchase of goods if other conditions are satisfied. अब आपका क्वेश्चन होगा कि एक डेवलपर अगर एक इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी परचेस करता है तो क्या उसे भी टीडीएस डिडक्ट करना पड़ेगा? एज आई एक्सप्लेन दैट गुड्स मींस एवरी काइंड ऑफ मूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी सब्जेक्ट टू सर्टेन एक्सेप्शंस एंड इंक्लूजंस. दस द इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी शैल नॉट बी ट्रीटेड as goods. Accordingly, TDS under section 194Q shall not be deducted on purchase of immovable property by a developer. अब आपके मन में ये क्वेश्चन आ रहा होगा कि अगर मैं कोई इलेक्ट्रिसिटी का ट्रांजेक्शन करता हूं तो क्या उस पर भी TDS डिडक्ट करना पड़ेगा? Whether TDS is required to be deducted on the transaction in electricity. Friends, Honorable Supreme Court, in the case of State of Andhra Pradesh versus National Thermal Power Corporation Limited, that is NTPC, reported in 2002-5 SCC 203 held that electricity is a movable property, though it is not tangible. Hence, it is a goods. Thus, it can be inferred that the tax is required to be deducted from the payment made in respect of the transactions in electricity. A transaction in electricity can be undertaken either by way of direct purchase from the company engaged in generation of electricity or through power exchanges. CBDT has clarified that transaction in electricity, renewable energy certificates and energy saving certificates traded through power exchanges registered under Regulation 21 of the CERC shall be out of scope of TCS under the provisions of section 206C 1H. Applying this rationale behind such clarification, it is expected that CBDT may allow a similar exemption from TDS under section 194Q as well. अब आप पूछेंगे, सर अगर मैं सॉफ्टवेयर परचेस करता हूं तो क्या मुझे टीडीएस डिडक्ट करना चाहिए? Whether TDS should be deducted on the purchase of software. Friend, taxation of software has always been a subject matter of debate under Income Tax. Finance Act 2012 has made the amendment in Section 9 to broaden the scope of taxation of royalty. This has been clarified by amendment that consideration for the use or right to use of computer software is a royalty. The factors of the medium, ownership, use or right to use, and location have been clarified as immaterial. The said amendments have given a new dimension to tax administration in the sphere of royalty taxation. Payment towards royalty is subject to TDS under Section 194J or Section 195. Provision of Section 194Q would not apply where tax is deductible under any other provision. In a landmark judgment in the case of Engineering Analysis Center of Excellence Private Limited, Honorable Supreme Court has held that payments made for software are not covered under Article 12 of the DTA, and Indian payers were not liable to withhold tax under Section 195 as no income chargeable to tax arose in India. This is only in the case of non-resident payments, and to this extent we may have to check whether Section 194Q would be applicable on this or not. TDS under Section 194Q is not applicable for payments made to non-residents. As far as payments made to residents are concerned, Section 194J is still applicable. And once Section 194J is applicable, Section 194Q will not be applicable. Hence, it can be concluded that Section 194Q will not be applicable for software payments where Section 194J and 195 are applicable. अब आप पूछेंगे कि अगर goods हमने purchase की है from e-commerce participant, तो कौन सा section apply होगा? 194Q और 194O. When goods are purchased by a customer from an e-commerce participant, would Section 194Q apply or 194O? Friends, Section 194O was introduced requiring deduction of tax by e-commerce operator while making payment to e-commerce participant. So far as the condition of Section 194O are satisfied, then tax should be deducted by the e-commerce operator under Section 194O, because Section 194Q is specifically exempt transactions that are subject to withholding tax under any other provisions of the Act. And Section 194O starts with a non-obstante clause and therefore overrides Section 194Q. Ab aap puchhenge ki sir, kya TDS deduct karna jaruri hoga agar main purchase karta hoon jewelry which is not connected with my business, that is for my personal use? Whether TDS is liable to be deducted on purchase of jewelry not connected with the business? My dear friends, there is no condition that purchase should be connected with the business only. Thus, if a person is falling within the definition of buyer, tax is required to be deducted
even if such purchase is not connected with the business carried on by him. Jewelry, being a movable property, is covered within the term goods. There is no specific exclusion under section 194Q for deduction of TDS on purchase of jewelry. Thus, the tax shall be deductible on purchase of jewelry if other conditions are also fulfilled. However, there might be practical difficulties in deducting the TDS by the purchaser, as the purchaser might argue that the jewelry is being purchased for personal use and not for business use. To avoid the genuine difficulty and confusion, necessary clarification from CBDT shall be the most welcome step. Ab aap ek question karenge, ki agar buyer ne ek financial year mein goods 45 lakh rupay ki purchase kari from the seller, usse pehle saal mein usne 40 lakh rupay ki goods purchase kari hai, aur phir wo seller 60 lakh rupay receive karta hai in dono purchases ke liye from buyer, इस केस में क्या TDS डिडक्ट किया जाएगा या TCS कलेक्ट किया जाएगा, ये मानते हुए कि सेक्शन 194Q और सेक्शन 206C1H की दूसरी सारी कंडीशंस पूरी हो रही हैं या कंप्लाई हो रही हैं. इफ द बायर हैज परचेस्ड गुड्स फ्रॉम सेलर वर्थ रुपीज 45 लैक्स इन वन फाइनेंशियल ईयर and rupees 40 lakhs in the preceding financial year, and the seller has received rupees 60 lakhs with respect to the two purchases made by the buyer, whether TDS has to be deducted or TCS has to be collected, assuming other conditions of section 194Q and section 206C1H are satisfied. My dear friends, since buyer has not crossed the threshold limit of rupees 50 lakh, however, seller has received amount exceeding threshold limit of rupees 50 lakh, hence, seller has to collect tax if all the conditions section 206C1H are satisfied in this case. Ab aap puchenge ki kya additional, allied and out of pocket expenses purchase value of goods ka part banenge ya nahi, whether they will form part of the purchase value of the goods. Whether additional, allied out-of-pocket expenses form part of the purchase value of goods. My dear friends, it is important to accurately determine the purchase value, as it is relevant both for the applicability of the provision and amount from which tax should be deducted. Where these expenses have been reflected in the purchase invoice itself, it should form part of the purchase value. However, more clarity from CBDT is awaited in this regard. Ab aap puchenge, ye jo rupees 50 lakh ki limit aapne batai hai, wo kis date se compute ki jayegi? Whether from 1st April 2021 or from 1st of July 2021. From which date the threshold limit of rupees 50 lakh will be computed? Similar confusion arose when section 206C1H was introduced by Finance Act 2020 with effect from 1st of October 2020, in respect of which CBDT, by circular number 17, dated 29 September 2020 clarified that since threshold of rupees 50 lakh is with respect to previous year, calculation of sale consideration for triggering TCS under this provision shall be computed from 1st of April 2020. Hence, if the seller has already received rupees 50 lakh or more up to 30th September 2020 from a buyer, TCS under this provision shall apply on all receipts of sale consideration on or after 1st of October 2020. Applying this principle as clarified by CBDT for TCS, it can be concluded that threshold of rupees 50 lakhs shall be computed from 1st of April 2021. Thus, if a buyer has already purchased goods of value of rupees 50 lakh or more up to 30th June 2021 from a seller, TDS under this provision shall apply on all purchases on or after 1st July 2021. Friends, अब आप पूछेंगे इस 50 लाख रुपीस की लिमिट के लिए बेस ईयर कौन सा होगा, विच इज द बेस ईयर फॉर द थ्रेशोल्ड लिमिट ऑफ रुपीस 50 लाख। तो दोस्तों, लिमिट ऑफ रुपीस 50 लाख इज कंसीडर्ड इन ईच फाइनेंशियल ईयर। द रुपीस 50 लाख एग्जेम्पशन इज फॉर वन फाइनेंशियल ईयर फॉर ए सिंगल सेलर। अब आप पूछेंगे कि सर, हम जो टीडीएस डिडक्ट करेंगे वो टोटल इनवॉइस वैल्यू पर होगा, यानी कि इंक्लूडिंग जीएसटी या फिर एक्सक्लूडिंग जीएसटी। वेदर टीडीएस इज टू बी डिडक्टेड ऑन द टोटल इनवॉइस वैल्यू इंक्लूडिंग जीएसटी। फ्रेंड्स, ए सिमिलर इश्यू वॉज रेस्ड इन रेस्पेक्ट ऑफ सेक्शन 194J फॉर विच सीबीडीटी White circular number 23/2017 dated 19 July 2017 clarified that wherever in terms of the agreement or contract between the payer and payee, the component of GST on services comprised in the amount payable to a resident is indicated separately, tax shall be deducted at source on the amount paid or payable without including such GST on services component. However, such clarification was issued in respect of GST on services only. No such clarification has been issued for GST on goods. However, in respect of section 206C(1)(h) CBDT by circular number 17 dated 29 September 2020 has clarified that since collection is made with reference to the receipt of the amount of sale consideration, no adjustment on account of indirect taxes including GST is required to be made for the collection of tax under this provision. Since deduction under section 194Q is to be made with reference to the purchase value, applying the same principle, it can be concluded that GST shall form part of the purchase value. Therefore, the TDS is deductible on the purchase value inclusive of GST. However, a clarification in this regard from CBDT would be of great help and is requested. Ab aap puchenge, sir, kya loading and unloading charges, packing charges, freight charges aur doosre incidental charges bhi consideration for goods ka part banenge? To dosto, as long as such incidental charges are mentioned in the same invoice, it will form part of intrinsically linked with cohorts, and TDS shall be applicable on total invoice value, including such incidental charges. However, if a separate invoice is issued for the same, no TDS would be applicable, as packing charges alone would not constitute goods. Ab aap puchhenge, sir, humne seller ko advance payment kiya hai, to kya us par bhi hume TDS kaatna padega? Whether TDS has to be deducted on advance payment made to the seller. Dosto, section 194Q provides that tax is required to be deducted in the transaction relating to the purchase of goods. It does not mention whether such purchase need to be effected immediately or at a future date. As the tax is required to be deducted at the time of payment or at the time of credit, whichever is earlier, it is reasonable to conclude that the provision may get attracted even if such purchase happens in future, as long as the intention is to adjust the advance payment against the future purchase of goods. The tax should be deducted at the time of payment or credit, whichever is earlier. If the advance payment is not paid with an intention to adjust it against future purchase, deposit or loan, but eventually it is adjusted against the future purchase, no tax is required to be deducted at the time of payment of such advance. In such case, liability to deduct tax will arise the moment such advance is adjusted against the purchase value of goods. In most of the cases, the payment of advance would be made only for the purchase of goods. Hence, it would be appropriate to deduct TDS under section 194Q at the time of payment of advance itself. Ab aap puchhenge, agar maine advance payment kiya hai before 1st of July 2021 for purchase of goods, to kya us par bhi mujhe TDS kaatna hoga? Whether payment of advance before 1st of July 2021 for purchase of goods will be subject to TDS. Since Finance Act 2021 has inserted section 194Q with effect from 1st July 2021, therefore, provisions of this section shall not apply on any payment made or credit made in the books of accounts before 1st of July 2021. Tax should be deducted where payment is made or amount is credited on or after 1st July 2021. Thus, where any of the payment or credit has occurred before 1st July 2021, no liability to deduct tax will arise. However, while booking the actual invoice, if the threshold limit has crossed and other conditions are satisfied, buyer has to deduct tax on the amount exceeding the threshold limit as on the date of booking of the actual invoice. Ab aap puchhenge ki agar maine seller ko advance diya hai as a loan, to kya us par bhi ye provision lagu hoga? Whether amount advanced as a loan to seller shall come within the ambit of this provision. The requirement to deduct TDS under this provision arises if the purchase value exceeds the threshold limit during the previous year. since the loan advanced by buyer is not a payment towards the purchaser of goods, it shall remain outside the purview of this provision. There is no requirement to deduct TDS on loan advanced by the buyer. However, if at any future date said loan amount is settled against purchased value, the liability to deduct TDS shall arise. The debt shall be deducted on the date on which parties agreed to adjust the loan amount against the outstanding liability. Friends, अब आप पूछेंगे कि क्या TCS applicable होगा under section 261H on the amount collected against invoices raised before 1st July 2021 if all the conditions of section 261H satisfy होती हैं. Whether TCS is applicable for the amount collected against invoices raised before 1st July 2021 if all the conditions of section 261H are satisfied. Since TDS is applicable only after 1st July 2021, therefore TCS is applicable for the amount collected before 1st July 2021. अब आपका अगला क्वेश्चन आएगा, सर अगर SSC की एक ब्रांच ने दूसरी ब्रांच से गुड्स परचेज करी है तो क्या इस पर टैक्स डिडक्ट करना पड़ेगा? Whether tax is to be deducted on the purchase of goods by one branch of NSSE from another, TDS under this section is required to be deducted by any person being a buyer responsible for making payment to the seller for the purchase of goods. Thus, the existence of two distinct parties as seller and buyer is a prerequisite to treat a transaction as purchase. Since condition of purchase is not fulfilled in case of branch transfer, therefore provisions of this section shall not apply in the case of branch transfers and no TDS is required to be deducted. What shall be the treatment of debit or credit note for computation of TDS? Whether effect of credit note or debit notes is required to be given to identify deductible amount? Before I answer this, let us look at provisions of section 261H and corresponding clarification issued by CBDT by circular number 17/2020 in respect of section 261H. TCS is collectible on any amount as consideration for sale of any goods of the value or aggregate of such value. CBDT mentioned that no adjustment on account of sale return or discount on indirect taxes, including GST, is required to be made for collection of tax under section 261H, since the collection is made in reference to receipt of amount of sale consideration. In above case, CBDT assumed that sales return or post-sales discount are provided after receipt of sales consideration. Many a times, sales consideration is adjusted by discounts and returns, and only net sales consideration is received by seller. However, such fact was clearly ignored while clarifying and gross invoice value was liable for collection of TCS. Ideally, purchase value should be adjusted to give effect to debit and credit notes issued for purchase return, discount, rate changes, etc. to arrive at actual transaction value. However, after referring above circular, a logical conclusion may not always be correct. A clarification from CBDT would bring more clarity. अब आप पूछेंगे कि सर अगर there is purchase return तो क्या उसको एडजस्ट किया जाएगा उस रुपीज 50 लाख की थ्रेशोल्ड में से जो एक साल की है और कंप्यूटिंग the TDS whether purchase return should be adjusted for computing the threshold of rupees 50 lakh in a financial year. My dear friends, threshold of rupees 50 lakh is to be computed considering the consideration paid for purchase of goods, and thus their goods are returned, value of such goods shall be reduced for arriving at threshold of rupees 50 lakh. However, said purchase returns ought to have been made on or before the point of tax deduction, as the threshold of rupees 50 lakh has to be checked at the point of time when liability to deduct at sources arise. Any subsequent returns cannot be considered. अब आप पूछेंगे कि बॉक्स कॉन्ट्रैक्ट के केस में अगर एक सिंगल इनवॉइस इशू की जाती है तो क्या टीडीएस एप्लीकेबल होगा अंडर सेक्शन 194 क्यू. सो द इशू ऑफ एप्लीकेबिलिटी ऑफ टीडीएस ऑन बॉक्स कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इफ सिंगल इनवॉइस इज इश्योर. ए कंस्ट्रक्शन कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इन्वॉल्विंग सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स लेबर एंड अदर सर्विसेज इज नाउ classified as a service under the GST regulation. However, if a single invoice is issued with no bifurcation into value of goods and services, the question then arises whether the provisions of TDS and TCS are applicable on the single invoice. Section 194Q5A provides that the provisions of 194Q shall not be applicable if tax has been deducted under any other provisions of the Act. Hence, if TDS is deducted under any other section on the full invoice amount, such as Section 194C, then TDS under 194Q is not applicable. अब आप पूछेंगे कि सर सेलर की मल्टीपल यूनिट्स हैं, यानी कि एक से ज्यादा यूनिट है और उसने जो परचेज करी है फ्रॉम डिफरेंट यूनिट्स, क्या उनको एग्रीगेट किया जाएगा. इफ द सेलर हैज मल्टीपल यूनिट्स, वेदर परचेज मेड फ्रॉम डिफरेंट यूनिट्स नीड टू बी एग्रीगेटेड. डियर फ्रेंड्स, where tax is required to be deducted at source. The deductee means the person from whom tax is to be deducted is required to furnish his pen to the deductor, failing which the tax is required to be deducted at higher rate. If pen is available, the threshold limit of rupees 50 lakh shall be computed in respect of each pen. In other words, if different units of the seller are under the same pen, the amount paid or payable to all such units shall be aggregated to compute the limit of rupees 50 lakh. अब आपका question आएगा कि अगर मैं goods transfer करता हूँ for testing purposes के लिए तो क्या उस केस में भी टीडीएस एप्लीकेबल होगा अंडर सेक्शन 194Q. सो यू विल आस्क द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ ट्रांसफर ऑफ गुड्स ऑन टेस्टिंग पर्पसेस अंडर सेक्शन 194Q. सेक्शन 194Q प्रोवाइड्स दैट बायर शैल डिडक्ट टीडीएस ऑन परचेज ऑफ गुड्स. हियर गुड्स आर ट्रांसफर्ड फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ टेस्टिंग no purchase is made, this provision will not apply. अब आप पूछेंगे सर क्या मैं lower deduction certificate for TDS के लिए भी apply कर सकता हूँ? My assessing officer, whether TDS under section 194Q will apply to redemption of preference shares by a company. Preference shares are movable property and goods. In Anarkali Sarabhai versus CID reported in 1997, 90 Taxman 509, the Honorable Supreme Court held that redemption of preference share is clearly sale by the shareholder to the company and would come within the purview of transfer in view of that a reading of section 67, 55 and 43 of the Companies Act 2013 makes it clear that when a preference share is redeemed by a company, what a shareholder does is to sell the shares to the company. Such a transaction is nothing but the sale of preference shares by the shareholder to the company. That is why, after specifically laying down in section 67(1) of the 2013 Act that no company shall have the power to buy its own shares, it was necessary to specify in subsection 4 of section 67 of the 2013 Act that this provision shall not affect the rights of a company to redeem any preference shares issued by it. If redemption of preference shares did not amount to sale, it would not have been necessary to specifically provide that the restrictions imposed upon a company in respect of buying its own shares will not apply to the redemption of preference shares issued by the company. Therefore, it appears that if redemption proceeds to any preference shareholders exceed rupees 50 lakh limit, TDS under section 194Q would apply as it amounts to purchase of goods. However, a suitable clarification by CBDT shall go a long way in settling the dust on this issue. Whether TDS under section 194Q will apply to buyback of shares by a company, will said buyback amount to purchase of goods? It would clearly amount to purchase of goods. It would clearly amount to purchase of goods in view of the Honorable Supreme Court decision in Anarkali Sarabhai versus CID, reported in 1997, 90 Taxman 509. Besides, section 68 of the Companies Act 2013, dealing with buyback of shares, refers to it as purchase in the section heading as well as text of the provisions. However, buyback of shares by domestic companies are subject to 20% tax under section 115QA of the Act, and the consideration is exempt from tax in the hands of the shareholders under section 1034A. Hence, it will be a case of fully tax-free income being subjected to TDS. Besides, section 115QA4 prescribes that the tax paid by the company under that section shall be treated as final payment of tax in respect of distributed income on buyback of shares. In view of this, it appears no tax under Section 194Q shall be deductible on buyback of shares. It is better that CBDT issue a suitable clarification on this issue in order to remove this ambiguity. My dear friends, lower deduction of TDS certificate is issued by assessing officer under Section 194C, 194J, 194I, etc. Even certain SSEs have an option to file a declaration for nil deduction of tax. However, Finance Act 2021 has not extended the benefit to apply for a certificate for deduction of tax at lower rates or to file a declaration for nil deduction in respect of transactions covered under Section 194Q. Hence, you don't have an option to approach the assessing officer to issue a certificate for a lower deduction or to file a declaration for nil deduction in respect of the transactions covered under Section 194Q. अब आप पूछेंगे कि सर सेलर की टैक्स कलेक्ट करने की जिम्मेवारी कब और कैसे अराइज होती है? When and how the seller's responsibility to collect tax arises? The primary onus to deduct tax is on the buyer. However, if the buyer does not deduct tax, the onus to collect the tax shifts on the seller. The seller has to collect the tax when he receives the amount as his consideration. Hence, at the point of receipt of his consideration, seller has to ensure from the buyer that the buyer has deducted the tax. If buyer has not deducted the tax, seller has to collect the tax. Seller can obtain a declaration from buyer regarding the status of tax deduction at source. It is to be also noted that since Section 194Q is applicable from 1st of July 2021, the seller has to collect tax on the sales consideration received prior to 1st July 2021. अब आप पूछेंगे कि मैं इस TDS को जमा कैसे करूंगा? How to deposit the TDS under Section 194Q? A corporate SSE and other SSEs will have to make payment of tax, including TDS, electronically through internet banking facility or by way of debit cards. To deposit the tax, the deductor has to fill the challan number ITNS 281. Other deductors can deposit the tax so deducted into any branch of the RBI or the State Bank of India or any authorized bank. अब आप पूछेंगे कि जो मैं ये TDS deduct करूंगा उसको मुझे कब तक जमा कराना है सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट के साथ? What is the due date to deposit the TDS? Tax deducted from the month of April to February in a year is to be deposited within 7 days from the end of the month in which tax is deducted. However, for the month of March, it can be deposited on or before 30th of April. अब आप पूछेंगे कि क्या मेरे खिलाफ कोई एक्शन लिया जाएगा by Income Tax Department अगर मैं ये टैक्स डिडक्ट नहीं करता हूँ अंडर सेक्शन 194Q या मैं उसे डिपॉजिट नहीं करता हूँ आफ्टर डिडक्शन विद गवर्नमेंट, व्हाट शैल बी कंसीक्वेंसेस फॉर फेलियर टू डिडक्ट और टू डिपॉजिट द TDS इफ एनी पर्सन responsible for deduction of tax at source fails to deduct the whole or any part of the tax or after deduction fails to deposit the same to the credit of the central government, then he shall be deemed to be an SSE in default. If deductor fails to deduct tax at source, he shall be liable to pay interest at the rate of 1% for every month or part thereof on the amount of tax he fails to deduct. However, if he fails to deposit the tax deducted at source, he shall be liable to pay interest at the rate of 1.5% for every month or part thereof on the amount of tax he failed to deposit to the credit of central government. In addition to this, 30% of the purchase value, which was liable for TDS, would be disallowed while computing the taxable income of the buyer under section 40AIA of the Act. अब आप पूछेंगे कि सर क्या buyer को SSE in default ट्रीट किया जाएगा अगर सेलर पे कर देता है टैक्स ड्यू ऑन इनकम डिक्लेयर्ड इन हिज रिटर्न ऑफ इनकम, वेदर बायर शैल बी ट्रीटेड एज एसएससी इन डिफॉल्ट इफ द सेलर पेस द टैक्स ड्यू ऑन द इनकम डिक्लेयर्ड इन द रिटर्न ऑफ इनकम. सेक्शन 201 ऑफ द इनकम टैक्स एक्ट प्रोवाइड्स that a deductor who fails to deduct tax at source is not deemed to be SSE in default if that payee has considered such amount while computing income in the return and has paid the tax due on such declared income. The deductor will have to obtain a certificate to this effect from a chartered accountant in form number 26A and submit it electronically with the department. Thus, the buyer shall not be deemed as SSE in default if the seller has taken into account the purchase amount while computing his income and has paid the tax due on the income declared. रिटर्न सेक्शन 194Q का सॉल्यूशन मैंने इस वीडियो में आपसे शेयर किया. तो उम्मीद करता हूँ आपको इस वीडियो में बताई गई जानकारी पसंद आई होगी. अगर पसंद आई हो तो मुझे लाइक का सिग्नल जरूर दीजिएगा. अगर आपको लगता है ये इंफॉर्मेशन किसी और के काम आ सकती है तो आप इस वीडियो को शेयर जरूर कीजिए. इसी तरह के वेरियस कॉम्प्लेक्स टॉपिक्स को मैं सिंप्लीफाई करता हूं अपने यूट्यूब चैनल CABN Infoventry पर. तो अगर आपने अभी तक मेरे इस यूट्यूब चैनल को सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया है तो मेरे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कीजिए ताकि आने वाले सारे वीडियोस के अपडेट्स आपके पास आ सके और हम और आप मिल सके एक और इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक के साथ किसी और दूसरे वीडियो में. तब तक अपनी हेल्थ का और अपनी वेल्थ का अच्छी तरह से ख्याल रखिए. बाय बाय.